Yup, yup.
I have no idea why you have on Chiefs gear, but thoughts on today's show?
Oh, yeah, I definitely. I want to hear him get to this big dummy of the day.
Yeah.
The big dummy of the day, somebody said, and you've been doing good for about 3 months. We crossed the line today. You said that Michael Thomas and Drew Brees was the best wide receiving quarterback tandem in the NFL. Did you forget about Tariq Hill, Patrick Mahomes?
Say his name first. If you, can you say his name right first
Tyreek so I
can
know? Hill,
Tariq Hill?
This man's...
No blackify his name.
Look, me. Look here, y'all had daddies. Leave me alone.
All right, I ain't forget about him. Here's a highlight from our discussion earlier about LeBron James.
A lot of home runs, no singles, though.
The top NBA players know what I'm talking about. LeBron James's unquenchable thirst for attention creates unnecessary drama that undermines a team.
What I love about LeBron is he's not a prisoner of his own success. We say he wants the attention or those guys want the attention, but in reality, it comes with the territory, so why not embrace it?
All right, Uncle Jimmy, we had a great discussion earlier about LeBron James, and as I explained, I was talking about this was the AAU thing is enlightening about LeBron as a basketball player. Anyway, what's your take?
You know, the great Muhammad Ali said that he was so fast that he could shut off the light and jump in the bed and be under the covers and sleep before the room got dark. Mm-hmm. My nephew used to practice that when he was growing up.
When?
No, for real. My nephew, hey, man, my nephew is a tricky person, man. You didn't see what he did to y'all.
What'd he do?
Look here, man. Let me tell you what he did, man. Mm. You see my nephew in one place. He'd be right here. And then all of a sudden, he'd be like, ta-da! And I'd be somewhere. He'd be somewhere else. Mm. You didn't see it, did you?
No. Nah.
Hey, man, listen to you. I know what you're thinking. With as much mass and as much ass as my nephew has, he shouldn't be able to move that fast.
Okay.
But the boy is as graceful as gazelle and slick as snail snot. Hey, bro, I done seen this boy as a kid try to hide behind a broomstick. And damn near got away with it.
Turbo, huh?
Here's your what I'm trying to say. Margulis.
What?
He moved the goalpost on us.
What'd he do now?
He changed the conversation.
Okay.
Let me tell you what he did. He got in a crowded room and yelled, get your hand out of my pocket! And then everybody turned around. We looked up. He was gone.
Where he go? What
you see what I'm saying? Let me look here, bro.
Break it down.
This dude sat up here all day yesterday and let me and you sit up here and defend his name and reputation all over the world. Talking about him and his comments about LeBron James. Mm. And he gonna sit there talking about, I never talked about LeBron and the father. I was talking about LeBron the athlete.
Oh, yeah.
Now you want to sit up here smiling like a wolf with a mouth full of yellow jackets. Talking about, you know good and well what the hell I'm talking about.
Yeah,
I was talking about LeBron the athlete, yes.
Today.
Look, you didn't see it coming, did you? Because that's what he do. He good.
That boy good.
Well, that boy good. Look, man, this is why I tell you, Uncle Jimmy too old of a cat to be clawed by a kitty. Look, man, the boy don't amuse me. I'm not amused by his foolishness. Look here, man, let me tell you what he did back in Kansas City one time. Back, I think it was 05. Mm. The boy wrote that the Chiefs was going to go 16-0.
1998.
So, oh, 90, oh, sorry, oh, yeah, wow.
Go ahead, man.
I stand direct.
Go ahead.
You're getting old, Uncle.
The man said the Chiefs going to go 16-0. Chiefs lost their first game. My nephew became rich talking about the Kansas City Chiefs and how bad they was. Here's the catch.
Not that fast.
Nobody on the Kansas City Chiefs thought they was going to go 16-0.
Yeah, yeah.
And he go around locker room talking about, what happened to y'all? That's why Wayne Simmons going to whoop his ass in Diamond Joe.
As he should have.
I got one more for you real quick.
Give it to me.
Listen, now this 2005, 2006. Mm. The no salary cap limit soldiers.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Look here, man. My nephew sat up here and tried to strong arm Carl Peterson and the Kansas City Chiefs to make him sign Ty Law.
That's right. No salary cap.
No matter what the consequence, no matter what the salary cap.
Sign Ty Law, you damn.
Look here, man, for 2 weeks. Longer than 2 weeks, all we did, he gonna make the Chiefs sign Ty Law. Hey, man, we made t-shirts. Hey, man, his jersey sales went out the window. We planned a pep rally down at in the Crown, down in Crown Center at the Foolery Saloon.
The Grand Saloon.
The Grand Saloon.
The Grand Saloon.
The Foolery Saloon.
Look here, man, we had 5,000 people there.
Boycott.
Everybody was there, but guess who wasn't there?
Ty Law and Jason.
My nephew. Hey, man, you heard about that big meltdown he had on TV? Remember he talked about that?
No.
Yeah, his whole big...
The day before the rally, Marcellus, I quit the radio show.
He quit?
Because he couldn't get Ty Law?
We got Ty Law.
Wait a minute. You know how he do something dumb and everybody asks you why Jason do it?
Yeah.
You got to explain it. Hey, man, where your boy? I'm like, hell, I don't know where he's at. We looked up, bro.
We got to give our approval rating.
Leaving us
LeBron James.
I got him at a 6.
This is what 60? He does.
Yeah. Oh, I drop him in authenticity. He's always on stage. This, he's always performing.
Oh, man, I moved him up job performance. Lost Kawhi, got AD when keeping it dad goes wrong. But all that said, authenticity, had to drop you one. Responded with Lock.
See you tomorrow.
I love it.
In love. Oh, man. No mercy.